Why am I here? I think I got to figure it out, but it took a while. I'm over 60 and I'm just barely getting it fucking figured, okay? But I started asking this question when I was about 15 years old. So I want this video to be for younger people who are asking this sort of question. Why am I here? What the fuck's going on? What the fuck am I doing here? Yeah? It's like, I don't get it. I know. It's tricky. It's a bitch. Let me share with you why I think I'm here. Okay. Not so much as a baseline, but as a perspective from which to launch your understanding of why you are here. It's like, seriously, I'd like to know, what the fuck are you doing here? This planet is a POS, man. This is a piece of shit. It's like, what are you fucking doing here? Why did you incarnate? Hey, I don't know, what are you, teenager, early 20s? This is kind of the crowd I'm talking about here. But, you know, this is a good question for whether you're teens, 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, or 60s or beyond. I'm just saying. Why are you here? What the hell compelled you to come back to this? Okay. Well, to answer this question thoroughly, or to give it a good look, we should probably ask a few other questions. Like, when we ask, why am I here? We should define here. What is here? What do you mean here? I'm here and the now. Yeah, oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, by the way, I'm in a mood. I'm in a kind of a mood. And so I'm talking a little crazy here. But, yeah. When I say here, what am I doing here? I'm talking about physicality. I'm talking about third density reality. I'm talking about planet Earth third density reality. I'm talking about this wild and crazy planet upon which the super rich power elite are controlling and dominating. Not only that, but if you look at life from a multidimensional perspective, you understand better what planet Earth is about and why it is the way it is. This is, you know, why am I here? It's a philosophical question, right? So here we are. We're talking philosophy. And my personal perspective, and you can cut loose here and go, ah, this is bullshit, and you can go, you know, watch some other YouTube videos, or you can listen up to some more of my bullshit. And it's just bullshit, man. It's my story. You got to make up your own story. The only real story, like what is going on in life, it doesn't matter what I think, what the greatest philosophers in the universe think. It's only what you think. You listen to other people and you take it in and you look at your own experiences and you have conclusions and you have theories. But this world, this universe, all of life is only no better than what you think it is, what you believe it is or what it could be. It doesn't get beyond that. Truth is wonderful. But you create truth and you have to believe in something before it becomes that next level of wonderfulness, which we call truth. You know, have you heard the one where he believes it's true, but it's not true? Yeah. The one I like is the guy's getting fucking screwed. He's getting conned, right? The fucking con artist got his number, right? And this guy's getting whipped 8 ways from Sunday, and you can't talk him out of it. The guy's screwing you, man. It's like, cut loose on that dude. Don't be giving him your money. No, this is a good deal, man. I'm investing, and this is This is the big, this is the good stuff, man. And you know he's being conned. He believes it's true. So his belief, he believes his belief is the truth. Mind fuck, right? What's the difference between belief and truth? Big, long, philosophical conversation about that. Okay. So anyway, where was I? Why am I here? As a baseline or a place from which to launch your understanding of why you are here, sharing your story, your belief, your understanding, your truth about life, physicality, multidimensionality, the multiverse, the universe, alternate realities and parallel universes. How about the multidimensionality of self and consciousness? We are unfathomable. We are deep shit beings. We live simultaneously on many different dimensions and many different levels of experience. It's really wild and crazy and deep. So, let's let my cat open the door. Did my cat open that door? Somebody opened that door. Oh, well. So, yeah. Okay. So, why am I here? Why am I here? I think I'm here because I understand, before I came to this density, this world, this universe, physicality, I had an understanding of what this place was and what it's like and what it does to people. People like you and me. This world, this universe, this density is a mindfuck. It's dangerous, it's toxic, it's hard, it's hurtful, it's unkind, and it's a serious challenge. Okay? And it can be a trap, and it can be addictive. And some of the worst things in any universe are addictions. When you're addicted to something, you are compelled to do it. You want to do it. What makes an addiction addictive is that it, whatever it is, whether it's sugar, alcohol, drugs, sex, money, power, and there's gazillions of other addictions. Workaholic, chocoholic, there's all kinds of addictions. But what it means is that we are compelled to pursue those activities or those consumptions because it either makes us feel good or better than what we already feel, or it causes us to not feel bad or worse. In other words, addictions are those things that kill the pain and or bring us pleasure. So in physicality, we are always reaching toward pleasure in our pursuits, one kind of feel-good or another. It could be psychological or physiological feel-good, emotional feel-good, or spiritual feel-good. You know, being right. It's not physiological. I feel like I'm right. It's not so much an emotional feeling of feeling right or emotional but it's a spiritual feeling right, or feeling secure, safe. Okay, so there's these different kinds of feelings or states of consciousness that we enjoy, are pleasurable, or unpleasurable, or painful. And so those activities or substances or things that by consuming or imbibing or involving ourselves in, if they make us feel better, to such a degree that we depend on them to make us feel good or to take away the pain. They can become addictive. Okay. I'm rambling here. Sorry. Let me tie up this whole addiction thing. What makes something addictive is that not only will it give you pleasure or kill the pain when you take it or do it, but when you stop doing it, it in itself will cause you to feel depressed or unhappy. So you want to take more of it, you want to smoke another one, or you want to eat another one, or drink another one, or do another one, because the depression that it causes goes away when you do it again. It's really fucked up, is the point. Okay, and this universe, this physicality, physical universe, Earth, is full of that sort of thing. So it's very dangerous in that way. It's toxic. When a spiritual being gets engaged or involved in something like this, it's hard to break the cycle or the circuit of addiction. Okay. So yeah. So why are you here? Why am I here? I think one of the reasons I'm here is to help people understand this universe, what it's like, what it is, and what it's about, and how it affects people. And it's way more than what I can share here in this video in the last 12 minutes. I believe I'm here because I believe this universe is toxic. It's addictive, it's a trap, it's messed up. And I believe that most people, when they incarnate into this world, they have no clue about what the afterlife is like. They have no clue what life beyond the physical plane is like. They have no clue of what life was like before they incarnated. They don't understand the higher planes, the other densities in which they lived before they incarnated, their between lives area, or the higher planes where they resided before they chose to incarnate into physicality. Most people do not understand that world, that realm, that experience. And that world, well, let me put it this way. We are immortal. We are eternal as spiritual beings in consciousness. Before we came here, we were wide awake and aware. While we're here, we're wide awake and aware. When this physical body drops dead, yours, mine, you will be aware in the afterlife. We are eternal. We are immortal. But most people do not understand. Who they are, what they were, why they came here. And when they leave here, they wake up in the new world and they don't all of a sudden become really smart just because they died. It doesn't work that way. It's like we gather our experience in a lifetime. We gather our beliefs, our passions, our latest new understanding of life, our new philosophies on how life works. And for a lot of us, that's all we get when we drop freaking dead. You drop dead, you wake up in a new world, and you don't have thousands and thousands of lifetimes to rely upon for your great wisdom to make your next choice to incarnate again or not, to move on, to do this, to do that. No, all you got, maybe, is your lifetime that you lived. What did you learn? What did you believe? What are your fears, worries, and concerns? What are your values? What do you believe? That's all you get. You don't get your gazillions of past lives to rely upon. Not at this level of the game. At some other higher self level, yeah, maybe. Okay, but no, you drop freaking dead. You're wandering around, what do I do now? I don't get it. What did I do? And if you were bad, in other words, if you believe you were bad, there can be some people that done like 10 times more evil and bad shit than you ever thought of doing. And they don't think they were bad. So their body, physical body drops dead, they're in their afterlife. There's no guilt trip that they're running on themselves. No. No, they're good. What? And they remember what they did, and what they're about, and what they're doing, and where they're going, and do they want to go reincarnate into physicality and be mean bad again? Or do they want to change their ways and be a loving, kind, decent, compassionate person? Get some balance? Yeah. We have all these options. I'm just saying, just because you die, you don't all of a sudden get smarter, and you don't all of a sudden remember every freaking lifetime you ever had. It doesn't work that way. Not in physicality. This place is toxic. You are only as powerful as you believe you are. You can only do what you believe you can do. Or we can like move outside that box a little bit. And maybe you don't believe you can do this thing, but you think you might be able to, and then you give it a shot, and you can do it. Yay! In your afterlife, can you walk through the wall? Can you fly? I don't know. So you don't believe you can fly, but you think, maybe, and you give it a shot, and there you go. You can fly. Okay. I'm just saying that you and I are very powerful beings. We are eternal. We are immortal. But we are limited by what we believe. And when we live in this world, when we incarnate into a physicality with a mind wipe and we don't know anything about our past, and here we are now, we're going, what the fuck? We learn and grow and develop new systems of belief, new emotional responses, new values. And I believe we hang on to our innate, basic, deep values. I do. But here we are. And each lifetime is a clean slate, and you learn and grow, and you walk away from this lifetime, drop dead, wake up a new world, and you are the effect of what you currently believe. Yep. And that's how that works. So, hello. Bye. She's not even going to talk. Okay. Yeah. Daddy's on a wrap. Okay. So, yeah. So I think it's important for people in this lifetime to, whatever they're going to believe. Well, how do I say this? What you believe in this lifetime is important. And why I am here is to help awaken people to the possibilities, to how it might work, to how not just your life here in the physical world, which is I believe is very limited for most people, but it's like heads up when this body drops dead or you change vibration, you end up in a higher plane, a different dimension, different density. Heads up. Because what you believe will empower you or limit you. And why I'm here is to help people look at some possible belief systems or possible concepts of what may be true for them. Now, there's things that they're true for me, but it may not be true for you. But I want to help open up a person's thinking process, a way to look at life multidimensionally, because this physical reality is not the only game in town, and what we learn in mainstream society about the afterlife is pretty much bullshit, I think. What most of these those who teach about the afterlife are usually the religions about their own idea of heaven or afterlife. And that is full of half-truths, total bullshit, or nonsense. So it becomes our responsibility to look at the different possibilities and open up our minds, our beliefs, allow more and more empowering beliefs, and be more discerning of those ideas that we get from various teachings and religions and studies and philosophers that may limit us or cause us to feel fear, apprehension, or concern. Because I believe if it's causing fear, apprehension, or concern, there's something within that belief system or those teachings that is not being presented properly. I mean, there's a lot of negative weird shit going on planet Earth, but if you present it properly, you can see how you are still the empowered, most powerful being in the game. Or that same information could be shared with you, and it can be telling you how fucked you are. Okay. So there's a lot of this is about wordplay and how you digest your information, who's sharing it and how they share it. And so there. Is that enough ramble for you? Are you done?
That's enough. That's a complete waste of my 23 minutes and 12 seconds.
Okay, sorry. Sorry you listened for so long. No, actually, I'm actually honored that anybody would watch this over 5 or 10 minutes. As Google Analytics proves up, most people only watch about, 10 minutes of my shit. Before they go, oh my God. And they're out here. Anyway, moving right along. Thanks for watching. And why I am here, to wrap this up, why I'm here is to help enlighten people to different ways of looking at life and thinking how life is and all that stuff. And now why you are here, let's give that a few minutes. If you're wondering about this, the answer lies, I believe, in your yearnings and your deep desire for something. When you might be like a teenager. I was like 15 years old when I first took walks at night. I looked up in the sky, see all these stars. I go, why am I here? What's it all about? I felt this desire for answers. And as it turns out, 50 years later, I'm going, oh, why I'm here is to help answer that question. So I believe that if you're like a teenager or early 20s or 30s, and you're asking, why are you here? Look at your desire, your yearning. It's like, if there's something you're, and you may not have it defined as a question, but you will get the essence of the subject matter in that desire that, you know, if you're reaching, you know, you're reaching for truth, you're reaching for answers, you're reaching for understanding, comprehension, clarity, or maybe you're a feeling person. I'm a crown chakra person, intellect, knowing, all that stuff. But you might be a more of a heart person, and you will feel, you know, you feel for humanity, or you feel for people. So why you are here will have something to do with feeling, helping people feel better, something in that way. Okay. Now, some people are very strong in their third eye chakra, their brow chakra. That's the psychic, that's clairvoyant, clairaudient, that's clairhearing. Clairsentient is that clear knowing. It's third eye stuff. And so if you're like really visual and you hear, you can close your eyes and visualize things, and you can hear clairaudient, you can just imagine music and hear it, or replay a conversation in your head. You know, why are you here? If you have a yearning, it's a stirring deep inside about something like that, why you are here will have something to do with that. I believe. That's my theory. Okay. And other people, third chakra, that's the, we call it the solar plexus chakra, the support authority chakra. If you're really in, you feel like you're in command, or you want to help, you want to support, and you're a very supportive person, and you just feel it in your gut, and that's what you're about somewhere in your life, and you're trying to figure it all out. Why am I here? If you're getting it, you're feeling it here. Something about support, I would imagine. That's my theory. That's my understanding. That's my belief, my truth. Yeah. Why are you here? Do you want to help? And how that help manifests, or how you can do that, that's another story. But why are you here? Yeah. That's what I say. Okay. And so each chakra or each yearning, it doesn't have to align with chakras, but those are seven local areas that you can look at. But why am I here? Crown chakra. Help share the truth or my understanding of how things are on planet Earth, so as to empower people and help them, not just planet Earth, but physicality, this density. People need to know that the life goes on even more real than physicality, this matrix world. There's a more real universe than this, and it plays more fairly. This universe, stacked deck, doesn't play fair. Too much pain, mind control, mind fucking. It's not a good idea. This place needs to be understood and taken into perspective. People need to get that this is not the only game in town, that it's more important, or at least as important, the higher density, the higher plane of existence, so you can get some perspective. So when you snap out of this world here into their higher plane, your afterlife world, you're not boxed in with your own belief systems, thinking while you're outside the physicality, thinking that physicality is the only game in town or most important game. No, no. You need to broaden your perspective, reach, depth, and begin exploring the greater reality for all it can be and what it is, and get a better understanding of what it is, who's there, what they do, why they do it, how the greater reality, fourth density reality, interacts and interplays with physicality, third density reality. It's very important because people can drop dead all the time and they get into some aspect or some realm of fourth density reality or the higher planes, some other realm, limited focus, limited thinking, limited beliefs. It can fuck you up and keep you limited yet again, and you'll go back into physicality, more mind fucking, more limited beliefs, back into your afterlife, very limited, boxed in, back here. And there are other beings who can influence your thinking and feeling, who have an agenda to keep you in this loop. Not a good idea. And I'm here to help people break out of that cycle, that endless reincarnational cycle of getting you into physicality where they can reap the benefits of your love and life and energy and work you emotionally and spiritually to suck your energy. Okay? It's a whole nother story about who's doing that, what they call that energy and all that stuff. But I'm just saying. I'm on a roll here, or a ramble, whatever you decide to call it. Okay? All right, so I'm going to wrap it up. And thank you for watching and listening. And your comments are more than welcome. When you comment on my videos, under my videos, you're sharing your beliefs, you're understanding your truth. That's important. You may come up, you may believe some wild and crazy shit that is exactly what some other person needs to read. It's like, yeah, I believe that too. Yeah. We can help each other out and support each other in our understanding and beliefs about the greater reality, about physicality, and our relationship with all of this. So, if you're inclined to share your unique perspective on how all this shit fits together, you are more than welcome to do so in my forum under my videos. And I watch as closely as I can, and I literally block. I just any bullshit, any crap, any insulting stuff. I don't respond to it. I just delete rude, insulting trolls and shit like that. So okay, so I keep it safe and good for all of us. And so there's no arguing, there's no nope. It's just good, wholesome sharing of our understanding and philosophies of how all this stuff works. Because I'm here to help. That's why I'm here. All right? All right. And, share with what, if you have a feeling or a sense of why you are here, share it. I'd love to hear it. And other people would too. I'm thinking. Yeah. Okay. All right. Yeah. Thanks for watching my silly shit. And I will talk to you later, all right? Take it easy now. Bye-bye.